I wish there was a way I could pause this while I'm recording. I don't see any way of doing that. Because the garden is really taking off pretty good. Our little illegals here, we got 50 pounds of sugar. Two 25-pound bags of sugar for these guys. And look at that one there is half full. That one's empty. That one down, well, you know, there's just the very bottom. Empty, empty, empty. And those there, because they're four cups. That one there's half, and this one here is half. The others are down, like I said, below that red lip there. If there was any in there, it'd be just a very little bit. So, one cup of sugar to three cups of water. And that's about a cup right there. That's about a cup. These are three cups, I think. So, they're drinking the crap. They're drinking the hell out of this stuff. Iced coffee. Oh, this evening I'm going to make a video out here. I'm going to sit out here with this video camera, and you're going to see the swarm that we have here. And this is June 4th, 2015. Last year at the end of the year, we had around 30 to 40 of them. And there's close to 60 out here when they all get down here and start feeding around between 5 and 7 o'clock. I mean, they're all over here, and we've got one of these large feeders on the side by the garden. And there'll be about 4 to 6 back on that. On the back porch, there's a small one with one broken feeder, so there's only 3 feeders, but they fly more times when they're feeding. So there'll be one back, there'll be 3 back there. Last year in the summertime, we had the sprinkler inside the bird bath over there. They would fly through it to cool off. And depending on if man God's going to let it get hot this summer, might have the sprinkler out there again for them. Jeez. I can't see if that's a seed under here or not. I can't even see it on the screen here now. Might be a pepper seed. That's how small the pepper seeds are. Which, I'm just going to stand on the porch here and start going over there. Oh, you can't really see them at all either. In garden number 2, along the eastern edge, close to the sunflowers there, I've got 7 pepper plants I put down. My wife and I put down. I can't see how small they look. And then in the next row, I got 2. Right in there, there's 2 pepper plants. We got 4 heirloom tomato plants over there. And that tank's gonna hide one right there. You see the tomato steak? Oh, you can see all 4 of them. Where's that? Gosh, this really sucks with this thing. 1, 2, 3, 4. Painted ponies look like they were dying off. I planted 2 seeds in each of the 3 holes over there. Zucchini is growing like crazy over there. Let's see if I can get that yellow one again. Through this broken viewfinder, it's hard to see this good. That big yellow one there. We got 13 and 14 inch zucchinis out of there earlier. Matter of fact, I'm gonna go in the house and record those while this is recording, since I don't know how to pause this. There's no pause on there when you're recording. Oh. Oh, I thought you were in the kitchen. This is 5 we got out this morning. 14. 13 and a half, about 11, around 10, 9 and a half, 10. So this is, I think, 10 and a half, 11. Zucchini. Plus, I gave my landlord two about the size like these two right here. Again, I can't see. Yeah, like these two. So, oh heck. Ow. I got peppers in here. I just planted the seeds for them, cayenne peppers, if they come up. It's late in the season, but I want to get more peppers. The first full week of June. See, these tomatoes aren't doing worth crap. Eggplant right here, these front three. Looks like they're overwatered, and I was sprinkling them. I wasn't watering them, I was sprinkling them every day, just to sprinkle. And then I think that might be the problem. I'm just gonna see. I have no more eggplant seeds. Heirloom, oh yeah, I do. I have to open up an envelope, that's right. So I can still get three or four eggplants growing here in a couple weeks' time. I got Marigold tomatoes down there, there's three of those. I got three. I can't read them now. I wrote down there and I can't even read them now. Marigold, Sioux, Super Sioux, and I just put heirloom tomato. I think they might be the cherry tomatoes. Which is, you know, anything about cherry tomatoes, two cherry tomato plants would be more than enough. Unless you just can live on cherry tomatoes, because they will just, they'll more or less overtake the garden. That's what they did the year before last. You know, I had like eight tomato plants out there. And, like I say, trial and error, I messed up a lot. But you get a cherry tomatoes and they'll just take over. And then they'll keep growing the year after, last year. There was a year before last, because last year then they were growing up all over again too. These are mostly these torch sunflowers out front here. On the end here. That's why next year I'm going to put those all around the garden with the torch. And then these titans will be sporadic with the torch, because the torch, look how big the leaves are. Nice and shady compared to the titan. So they're thick. Again, trial and error, I put them in too thick. But they look like they're gonna be okay. What's this? Oh, see, now this is a pumpkin. These are pumpkin plants too, by the way. We kept saying they were zucchini, they're pumpkin plants. Zucchini are the ones that are like a big, thick bush. The ones that are have the long runners on them are pumpkin. God, see the pumpkin down there? Again, I can't see if I can see it. Right there, you can see it. I'm underneath the crack, that's why it's down there, where it is. That's the middle of the screen, the crack's going right across it, the big black mark. So, these are pumpkin plants, there's five here. More than enough pumpkin. We might have three next year. Put them down here at this end of the garden too, where the okra is at. We'll put one there, again I can't see there. One up there, and one back over here. Because they'll run that way, about the length of this. This is 25 feet or so. This is 14 feet and they're coming out on here. My painted ponies, we're doing good. And I don't know what the heck happened with the rain. We had heavy rains and heavy winds out here. You can see how crappy that looks. I put two more down there, two more seeds. Same thing with this one. I put two seeds down there with that one. God, look at how bad these look. So, and the heirloom tomatoes right there. Runner bean. Tomatillos at the end down there, two of them. Swiss chard. And I planted three pepper plants that I know were pepper plants. One looked like it was a tomato plant, but we're not sure if it was a pepper or tomato. So we put it on the end here next to this one. This is a tomato plant. And then we'll put this one down. So everything we got, except with the exception of those four, have been from seeds that we planted. You know, so if you can't plant things from seed and have it come out like this. Those are cucumbers. Straight eight is that one, and the one in the middle there, I can't really see it as a viewfinder, but you got one straight eight, two right here, then another straight eight, and then the same as these other two. Runner beans. This is honeydew. This one was planted like almost four weeks after this one, because I had planted them and nothing was coming up, so I planted another one. Not sure if it would grow. I just put one seed down. Everything has been one seed, and then I started planting two, like I did with the beans. Now I got two and three plants in each one of those. That's a watermelon. That's a different watermelon in the back. See, these are the zucchini. See that big yellow one down there? Brand. That big one. You often see, these were seeded out here. I put the seeds out here in the ground, and this is what's come up to my waist. You see how wide they spread out. See here again, I went ahead and I said, well, you know, everybody keeps saying put down two or three. So I was putting two or three down. Now I want to show you something. I'll put the camera down. I can't get down there. But you'll see two or three stems, because there's two or three growing there, because I put two or three beans down there. Put two or three down for all of them, and I got two or three growing out of every one of them. Solutions from Science is where I got my seeds from. And, you know, every seed that I planted, everything grew. That's why I get confused when I see something like this here. It should be a golden zucchini out of that space right there. These sweet peas too, because the heat and the wind. I'm trying to keep this stuff up. I mean, like I said, I'm learning as I go. I planted fresh peas down here. You know, put down two in all these spaces where you don't see anything. Like there and there's two peas and two peas to grow. So, look at this watermelon. I mean pumpkin coming all the way out here. That's about 14 feet coming out of the garden over there. It's another 3 feet into the garden, 4 feet into the garden. So we planted some more sunflowers because I threw fertilizer on them. Not really thinking, I got it on the plants and burned them. So my wife sowed more sunflower seeds down here for me. You see that on the side there? Look at how thick that is. That's how it should look all on there. And I left a break there. And then all this should look in like that side. See right there, more was sewed in here. And I did a break here for the walkway we made and put more sunflowers here. So it should, like I say, look like that back wall, that back edge. It should look like that all the way around here. Here's those peppers I planted with my wife. Damn, I can't see with this viewfinder. Anyway, it's June 4th, 2015. It's around 11:30, maybe 12 o'clock. So, we'll see. About 2 weeks from now, we'll see what they look like if they take good.